Portrait is a relationship between an artist and the subject, between the artist and the sitter. And in many ways, it's a dialogue. The sitter has certain things that he or she wants to project, certain claims to status, eminence, handsomeness, beautifulness, social status, wealth, and usually, the artist attempts to oblige. Portraits represent a subject, but they are not the subject, him or herself. In many ways, they are a fiction. In many ways, they're an ideal image of a person. It's the way that you want to look as a person. And this is true even of photography, the most so-called mechanical of the arts. The camera is heavily reliant on the expertise of the photographer. And there's still a great deal of framing, a great deal of composition, a great deal of lighting that goes into any, even the most rudimentary photograph. When you're looking at a portrait, you have to think about the life, that this is Abraham Lincoln, but you also have to think about the way in which the image portrays that life, where it lines up with what we know or think we know about Lincoln, or what we hope or what we want to be true of Lincoln. And this is where you get away from strictly factual history, that this is Abraham Lincoln, because it's not. It's an image of Abraham Lincoln on a particular day in February, and then now, 150 years later, we're looking at it back through 150 years of American history. And it's a fairly complicated task to move in between the present and the past, that we're looking at two different things at the same time. But it's also a technical work of art, either in the photography of Alexander Gardner or the paintbrush of Gilbert Stuart for his Washington or any of the other wonderful artists that we have in our collection.